Okay, everybody, it has been a very long time since I've come back to this project, but here we are. I'm now working in engine 4.19 preview 6, so it's in beta version, and I'll show you the reason why I'm doing that. But that is probably newer than, well, that's definitely newer than the videos that I have been using up until this point, where I'm using like 4.7 of the engine. So a lot has changed in the workflow. A lot has changed in my knowledge of different tips and tricks to get through all these different problems that one may have as they're trying to do these projects. So I'm going to do a more updated workflow for newer engines and go back and adjust some of these things and show some more advanced settings as well. So let's start with the workflow for getting your 3D Studio Max into Unreal Engine. And we'll start by bringing in a new piece of furniture. And depending where you are in the class and what you've watched, you may not even have that piece of furniture yet, but that's okay. So as you may or may not have seen already, there is in the new engine, there's a tool called Datasmith, which is really quite essential for ArcViz artists that are trying to use real-time and VR. So let's get this updated into a project that has Datasmith capabilities. What we can do for that is just find this particular level, which is called First Person Example Map, and let's just migrate it to a new template that has Datasmith capabilities. Once we find the level in our content browser, we can right-click on it and say Asset Actions, Migrate. But we will need a place to migrate it to. So let's first set up a project that has Datasmith in it, and then we can migrate this level to it. So with 4.19, we have the option when we create a new project to say Unreal Studio. Let's just take that and use the product viewer, and we'll call it New Interior Project. Create. Okay, here we are in the basic project for a Datasmith project, and you can see we have this new button up here, Import Datasmith. And I've showed how to do that in the video where I demonstrated how to download, where to get Datasmith, how to download it, how to install it, and how to do basic imports. We're going to migrate our old file into this project so that we have all the Datasmith capabilities. So all we need to do is save this and close it and go back to our other project and then migrate that other project into here. Okay, so in this project, again, we find our level. And by doing the level, then it just grabs everything that this level needs. So that should basically be like our whole project, right? Okay, so any blueprints or anything associated that are going on in this level, it will bring those with it. So assets, asset actions, migrate, hit OK. It's showing you all the stuff that has to come with it. Okay, and then find the content folder for that new project we just created. New interior project, content, select folder, and it will migrate it over there. Content migration completed successfully. Okay, so now we need to go back and open that other project. I know it's kind of a lot of back and forth. Okay, new interior project opening up. Once we are here, then we can just open a level. First person example map. So double click on it, open it up. And here we go. Here's our level. It just opens right up with everything attached. It will have to build the shaders, obviously. Here they come. And the Datasmith stuff is there. So we just imported it into a Datasmith project. From here now, we'll start using Datasmith, and I'll show you kind of a newer and updated workflow, additional things that I've learned, and additional things that Epic Games has made available to us that really help out ArcViz artists. So let's continue from here in the next video.